everybody remembers the first performance from the evening when Adam talked a little bit about clap music. As you remember, it was clapping music. The piece was written by a guy named Steve Reich, who in 1972 decided that it would be really cool to bring some African rhythm into Western music. So Alex and I were really inspired by this, so we wrote our own piece of music with clapping called the Clap Scrap Boogie. But first, we're going to talk about some of the mathematical principles behind our music.
Okay, so first of all, we have rhythm, which is basically a combination of sounds and silences put together to form a pattern, and that pattern is a song. So in our song, our rhythm is comprised mainly of eighth notes, quarter notes, and rests, because it's pretty basic. And okay, so another important part of the rhythm is the time signature, which is the number at the top corner. It's those two numbers, one on top of the other. And the top number is the number of beats per measure, and the bottom number is the note that forms the unit. So in a 4-4 time, it would be 4 quarter notes per measure, and that's counted like 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And in a 3-4 time, it would be counted as 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, and so on. And our piece is comprised mainly of a 4-4 time, but in the beginning, we're going to have a polyrhythm.
So now I'm going to tell you what a polyrhythm is. A polyrhythm is when a composer, basically, it sounds like the composer is putting two different time signatures next to each other. But really what happens is they actually combine into one time signature. So, for example, what we're going to do is a 3-4, where the composer will take the 3 times the 4 to find the least common multiple, which in this case is 12. So the time signature becomes 12-8. And so now what sounds like a beat in 3-4 now looks like this, and what sounds like a beat in 4-4 now looks like this at the top. So real quick, I'm just going to demonstrate what a polyrhythm sounds like, so you can look for it in our piece. So my right hand was playing in 4-4, and my left hand was playing in 3-4. So another thing that you should look out for in our piece is called syncopation. A lot of times people don't just play on the downbeat, which is the hit when you're counting out music, but it's kind of the offbeat, and it has a lot of rests and dotted notes. So we're going to show you what a syncopated rhythm sounds like. Alex is going to play the downbeats, and I'm going to play the offbeats. On the offbeat, creating syncopation. And lastly, you remember Noelle talking about timbre. Yes, for the most part, we will be clapping during our piece, but when we incorporate other parts of the body, there will be some changes in timbre and also a little bit of changes in pitch.
Okay, without further ado, this is the clap scrap boogie.